Hey, Lon, what you got on you? I got that shit on me tonight. I ain't gon' cap you down. No, for real. I got it on me.
How much you got on you? How much you got on you? Hey, how much you got on you?
It's just a 10.
Hey, how much you got on you?
It's a little 20.
How much you got on you?
It's just a 30.
How much you got on you?
I blow the 40.
How much you got on you?
I made it 50.
Hey, how much you got on you?
It turned into 60.
How much you got on you?
Then I spent the 70.
Hey, how much you got on you?
It came back with 80.
Hey, how much you got on you?
I came with a whole.
Hey, how much you got on you?
Bitch, I got a lot.
Hey, how much you got on you?
Y'all wanna fuck me?
Hey, how much you got on you?
She say I'm hot.
Hey, how much you got on you?
I got a lot.
Hey, how much you got on you?
Yeah, it's a lot.
I got a lot on me,
I got a lot on me,
but that ain't a lot of me.
That ain't a lot to me.
Talking about money, money, money.
Think I'm gonna cry. First of all, I just want to give a big thanks and shout out to Drift HQ. Wasn't really expecting this at all. Just coming home and end up seeing a big box on my front porch. I'm like, what is this? So I'm gonna open it. It was this. So this is the Road Race LS Swap Canton Pan, the front sump. So as y'all know, I already got one from I got the knockoff GX one. So let's be honest. But I know, seeing this, granted, I'm building another motor, so this actually is by far like amazing. I really appreciate y'all at Drift HQ for this. Let's go ahead and unbox it. Give me one moment. So, here it is, the Canton oil pan. So it has the dipstick tube up top for it, or you could do a return. Yeah, you can do a return in the here, or the dipstick on either side, or you can do the bone for return there for a turbo setup. Or you can do twin turbos up top, however you want to set it. Your drain plug is over here on the side. Like, this is the oil pan I actually wanted. It was so far out of my price range, I couldn't afford it. I'm not going to lie to y'all, I ain't balling like people think I'm balling. You got the baffle in there. Like I said, it's a Road Race Drift oil pan, so this thing is actually pretty nice. I already got the front, so hopefully the sump that I got will work on it from the other pan. It has the little trap doors in there. This thing is pretty sweet. Most of everything in the box, but I really do appreciate this a lot. Yeah, next all I gotta do is get a windage tray and get the front sump, and I have this one for the other motor. I didn't reach out, so that means y'all are watching my videos, and I really do appreciate that, especially for y'all to take the time out to send something like that to me. Like, I really appreciate that, 'cause I was having quite the day today, not gonna lie. And seeing this kind of made my day. I would love for y'all being a sponsor to me. But who knows? I know y'all got bigger fish to fry, so I don't really even bother y'all about that. But it'd be cool at the same time. But like I said, I really do appreciate this a lot. This definitely made my day. So yeah, let's get back into it. And also, for y'all that don't know who Drift HQ is, check them out. Drift, like I Drift, and HQ headquarters. Check them out. Look at their site and everything. And actually, I drop one of their videos right here.
Thank you.
back at it again, pulling the motor once again to cut the bolt. The die is supposed to be here tomorrow, so gonna pull this motor and get the ball rolling. So hold that thought. I'm gonna tap the GoPro on and start getting everything set up. I don't have anybody help me, so doing this on my own. So hopefully I don't hit my firewall and mess up the paint. So hold that thought, and I'll be right back. So here we are, we got the motor out now. So now I just gotta separate the trans and take the clutch off again. And then, yeah, so got the motor out, everything went smooth. Hopefully these stay once I go back in, so. Tired of this, man. Hopefully this is the last time that this motor comes out this car. Until the other motor gets here. So, just hold on. We'll get back to it. Now we wait. So, got it all disconnected. Left the bolts in so that way the flywheel don't fall out and the flex plate don't fall out. So, everything's disconnected now. So, hopefully this is the last time we'll be doing this. So, yeah. Tomorrow. So, hold that thought and I'll be right back. I almost forgot. So, while I get everything set the way it is, Facebook be really, like, stalking what you do. Like, I don't know if it's creepy or if it's a good thing. But anyway. So, I got this tool that locks the flywheel up to be able to do the cranking stuff. So, another thing, this little tool right here, it gets to cranking everything on. So there's this. So you put that bolt in first, or the stud in, and then you put the harmonic balancer on, and then you put nut on, tighten it down a little. I use the impact and impact it all the way in. So this is it. So this little nut, right? And then you get some little spacers. And then this ball bearing sits in between. So that ball bearing sits in between to keep you from scarring up the bolt and the washer. Helps it slide its way in there. Just like that, see how that is? So it does just that. Then you take your washer off, just like this. And then you get a crescent wrench and you basically twist this out. Like I said, this little it was on Facebook Marketplace. I stay on Marketplace. I live on there. How you find half things? How you finding? So that popped up right behind it. So I was like, all right, cool. Shot. Sure enough, worked just fine. So now I got this on. I didn't have to say they use their bolt to tighten everything down. No, I'm not doing that. Don't do that. This works great. You're not risking the fact on pulling your threads out like that either. So that works just fine. The bottom's out. Like I said, you twist the stud in there and the bottom's out just like it needs to, and then continue on with your day. And that crescent wrench is over there on the other side. So right now, got a sin. It's a mad thing. It's one of the things I wanted to do. I'm glad I thought about it before I just called it tonight. So now my harmonic balancer is finally on. It's another thing. Hopefully I'm not battling with this thing when I go put this motor in. I just realized that. Hopefully. But put a crescent wrench right there. The motor's still locked up. Now you're gonna do is turn like that. And then you just back it up out of there. Just like that. Just get the roly up out of there. See how long that thing is. So that's all it is. Then just stick your original bolt back in. Where is it at? So I'm using my impact. So hold on, one hand in this thing. Come on. Zip it, and I'm gonna put some Loctite on this. You know what? Put a little bit of Loctite. Better safe than sorry, right? So hold on, give me one moment. So Loctite is on the boat. That thing up in there. Blue Loctite, of course. I don't really use red. Need to go get some red tomorrow from like that. Back in, and we get torque spec, and I'm gonna torque it down to spec. But I need to get some red Loctite tomorrow. I forgot today. I got some orange. Orange is the new stuff. It's supposed to be like 3 times stronger than blue. So, it's still supposed to be a get out with tools. So, I'm gonna use that for these other bolts. But anyway, like I said, hold that thought, and yeah, just hold on. Hold on. So me measuring the washer, it gave me a 2.65. So if I can get this set up to that way. So right there is where it's Right here is where I need to cut. Oh, wait. So right about there. That will give me my cut that I need. And that should fix it right there. I don't know if y'all can see that I had it pretty much hold the camera with my chin, but cut it right there. And that should be all I need if I can get it to focus in. So that's about what? Almost two threads in. Right there. So cut it there and that should be good. I might have to come back just a little bit due to how thick my blade is going to be, but hey, as long as I get just a minute cut, you don't want too engagement, so just keep that in mind as well. They're supposed to be making new bolts and stuff, but that's still a few weeks out, so I'm just going ahead and do what I gotta do on my end and just cut it. But anyway, we'll get right back to it. Back again. I'm sorry. I didn't see the need to put a GoPro on this. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to explain. Well, I should already show y'all. So you're going to do everything I said earlier. You're using micrometer. I did. This one's from Harbor Freight. So this one's from Harbor Freight. All you need is 2 millimeters. Just cut 2 millimeters off. And then I'm going to use this. You're gonna roll it on before you cut. You're gonna put this on and then you're just gonna take it off. See how I got the cuts and everything? And then you're just gonna roll it back and forth till you clean the thread enough. Those are already cut. And then after you cut, you wanna double check to make sure that everything is good. So you wanna put them in and then rotate it back and forth, making sure your thread engagement is good. I don't like the way this one feels. Make sure your thread engagement is good, making sure nothing is out of whack, and so far so on. I'm gonna put the sock on the opposite side, run the bolts in, turn it over, and that's pretty much it. So I'm gonna start putting these in, and hopefully I can get this trans on my own. If not, let's wait till tomorrow. I really don't like the way this is feeling right now. Feeling kind of sketchy. But yeah, I'm going to get these in and call it a day. All right, so now the trans are back united. The clutch is all set up. So it's ready to go back into the car. Everything's ready and locked up finally. So good morning. Hopefully I have the help that I need to be able to drop this motor in. So we gonna conclude this for tonight. And we're gonna put the GoPro on once everybody's here tomorrow. So that's all what I thought. I'll be right back. Dollar bill, y'all, cash, everything around me, free, get,
dollar, 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 doll